Hi, my name is Dr. Fakhar Qazi. I'm one of the liver transplant fellow at UHN. I would like to highlight the issue of living donation in context of the patients who are underserved by MELD scoring system. We would like to develop a scoring system to identify patients waitlisted for liver transplantation who would particularly benefit from access to living donation. Liver transplant has been offered to patients with end-stage liver disease with excellent overall survival. However, a growing waiting list has increased the demand for organs while supply has not kept up. Therefore, waitlist mortality is as high as 25%. Current models of organ allocation depends on assessment of medical urgency for transplant and mortality on the waiting list using MELD and MELD sodium scores. These predictive models are based on objective laboratory parameters such as bilirubin, INR, creatinine, and sodium. Although MELD and MELD sodium models are excellent predictors of waitlist mortality, there are few limitations. These models do not consider the degree of physical decompensation such as ascites, encephalopathy, sarcopenia, and frailty. Moreover, the waitlist population has changed significantly over last decade since the time these scores were designed. Patients in the current era are sicker, older, have more comorbidities, and are less likely to be transplanted for viral hepatitis. The performance of MELD and MELD sodium remained excellent, although it has worsened over time from 2005 to 2015. Hence, their performance in the current era is of concern. Furthermore, women are particularly disadvantaged by the MELD scoring system for various reasons, such as low muscle mass, small stature, and serum creatinine not appropriately reflecting the renal dysfunction. In the setting of scarce deceased donor organs, living donor liver transplant has emerged as a viable alternative. Access to living donor liver transplant shortens the waiting time and decreases the waitlist mortality. We have found that in waitlist patients with NASH cirrhosis, having a potential living donor was associated with a higher instantaneous rate of receiving a transplant, particularly for patients who were older than age 60, diabetic, with height less than 165 cm, and a MELD sodium score of less than 20. We devised a preliminary scoring system taking into account these parameters to predict which of the NASH waitlist patients would especially benefit from access to living donation. We have separately found that access to living donor liver transplant particularly helps women as compared to men. We would like to therefore validate our model among other underserved populations such as women and patients with primary sclerosing cholangitis. We hypothesized that waitlist patients with NASH cirrhosis, primary sclerosing cholangitis related cirrhosis, and those who are female would be advantaged by having access to living donation, particularly if they are older, have systemic comorbidities, and have some degree of frailty. Given that our transplant program performs a significant number of both deceased and living donor liver transplants, we are in a unique position of being able to examine the impact of access to living donation on the waitlist outcomes in living transplant candidates. Fine and gray computing risk models will be built to examine the effects of availability of potential living donor on cumulative incidence of transplant, while death will be treated as the competing risk event. Additionally, machine learning methodology will be employed to construct a scoring system that incorporates these competing risk models and various features. The developed risk score would help identifying the patients and features particularly benefiting from access to living donation and will serve as a framework to particularly encourage living donation among patients currently underserved by the MELD sodium score.